Anyway, as a system professor of AIDS of AI systems IOID, in this session we see the 2D transformations related to different techniques we have. So almost all the graphic system allows the programmer to define the pictures of the variety of transformation. So transformation means what? In a computer graphics, transformation is the process of modifying and repositioning the existing graphics. So, for example, almost a programmer is able to magnify the picture so that the detail appears more clearly to reduce it so that the more picture is visible. So the programmer is also able to rotate the picture so that it can see in different analysis. So in this session, we see the how the 2D transformation works. So in that, in a computer graphics, the images are generated from a series of line segment in which are represented by the coordinates of their end point. Due to this, we can make the changes in image by performing the mathematical operations on these coordinates. So when we can change the image, we can call as the image is transformed. So we will have in this session we will see different images transformations depending on the different techniques for the transformation we will see. So the 2D transformation takes place in a two-dimensional plane, so that's why it is called as a 2D. So in a transformation, so in that we have x and y planes will be required for the transformations. So how the transformation will be helpful or advantages of this? The transformation is helpful for changing the positions of the size, orientation, shape, and etc. of a object of the object. So now we will discuss the different techniques for the transformation. So in that transformation in a computer graphic, there is a five techniques related to that. That is translation, rotation, scaling, reflection, and shear. Now we will see first one, that is translation. So how the translation will be work? So in that, in a computer graphics, translation is the process of moving an object from one position to the another in a two-dimensional plane, that is called as a translation. So now the translation, there is another definition of translation, is that translation is the process of changing the position of an object in a straight line path from one coordinate to the another location, that we call as a translation. So consider now see in the diagram. So there is a consider and point object O has to be moved from one position to the another in a 2D plane, that is O dash. So how this will be working in a real time, the algorithm related to C in this session. So now we can translate a two-dimensional point by adding a translation distance Tx, that is shown in the diagram, and Ty related to X and Y coordinate. Move the point to the new position, that is Y dash. So initial coordinate of the object O, X old and Y old. And the new coordinate will be of a object after the translation, that is x new and y new, and required that for the translation vector, or we can say the shift vector, that is from tx and ty related to x and y coordinate. So the translation vector tx and ty defines the distance x old coordinate has to be moved, and ty defines the distance y old coordinate has to be a move. So this is how the working of 2D translation. So now we will see how this achieving by adding the translation coordinate to the old coordinate. So x new equal to x old plus tx, that is the coordinates translated toward the x axis. Same for the y, that is y new equal to y old plus ty, which denotes the translation towards the y axis. So how this so in this diagram, that is translation matrix, we can represent the matrix translation equation in the matrix form. So that is x new and y new equal to x old y old plus your transition factor or the scale factor will be tx and ty will be added on that. So this is how the translation matrix. So related to this, we can go from the homogeneous coordinate representations of x and y is will be x comma y comma 1. That is the homogeneous coordinate representation. So through this representation, all the transformation can be performed by using matrix or vector multiplication. So the representations of a translation matrix in a 3x3 matrix, that is x nu, y nu, and the 1 equal to 1, 0, tx, that is your transition factor, 0, 1, ty, 0, 1, 1, that is 1, into your x old, y old, and 1. So this is the homogeneous coordinate representations of a translation matrix. So now we will take one example related to how this 2D translation will be performed in a equations form. We will see. So suppose we have the square, that is object, with the coordinate will be a, b, c, d, and the value will be 0, 3, 3, 3, 3, 0, and 0 respectively for the each and every coordinate. So apply the translations with the distance 1 toward a x-axis and 1 toward a y-axis. Obtain the new coordinates of that square. So in that given, we have a old coordinate, that is a, b, c, d. And your translation vector tx, ty will be 1, 1. So now we will calculate the your translation of a coordinate. That is, let's new coordinate of corner a will be x nu, y nu. So applying the translation equation, we can get x nu equal to y old plus cx, that is 0 plus 1 equal to 1 for related to a coordinate. Y nu equal to y old plus ty equal to 3 plus 1 equal to 4. So new coordinates of a corner a will be 1 and 4. So this is how the calculations of a new coordinate of a coordinate. Same for the b. Apply the translation equation, put the values on that x old and plus translation vector. We can get x nu and y nu for the b coordinate. Same for c coordinate, that is, we have x old 3 and y old will be 0. By using the translation equation, we can get x nu and y nu of a coordinate c, that is 4 and 1. Same for d. So we can get your corner a of 1, 4, b will be a 4, 4, c will be a 4, 1, and d will be a 1, 1. So after this, we can get the new coordinate of a square. So how this translation will be going on? So this is your newly old coordinate of a square. After the translation, it will move towards after translating. So this is the diagram of your equations that we have solved. So thank you guys, and we can summarize this topic. That is, we have seen the 2D transformation definition. In that, we first see the technique of translation. We have seen the how the translation will be worked, and one example of the translation. That's it.